The Ulm Minster is both impressive and unique.
This is the world's tallest church. Why does the steeple have to be so tall? How does it feel to fly around the tower? Why is it always under construction? How does it feel to play the organ? And how fast can I get up there?
The world's highest church steeple has got me curious. To find the answers to my questions, I go right to the top. 768 steps on foot. There's no elevator here. 143 meters closer to heaven, on the highest viewing platform, Pastor Peter Charles Ahlers is waiting for me.
Das war halt für die Ulmer ganz, ganz wichtig, dass sie.
It was extremely important for the people of Ulm to show the world the power and wealth they had amassed.
Manche sagen dann, es wie ein Finger.
Some say the steeple's like a pointer, a sign there's another dimension up in heaven. But to me, that sounds almost too pious to be true.
The church steeple is 161.53 meters tall. That's a world record. Ulm lies in southern Germany, right on the Danube. Today, the city has just under 125,000 residents. But Ulm was once a powerful and wealthy city. It was famous for its high-quality fustian, a fabric made from cotton and linen that was in demand worldwide. The Minster is a testament to the city's former prosperity. Not only is the steeple gigantic, so is the church's Gothic interior. I am one of around a million people who visit the Ulm Münster each year to marvel at its sacred artworks. It's the largest Protestant church in Germany.
Above all, it's a people's church. The idea to build it didn't come from a church or a bishop. It came from the citizens themselves. It's said the self-esteem of the people of Ulm is as high as the church tower itself.
This relief depicts the laying of the foundation stone in 1377. Early on, the people of Ulm were determined to build the world's tallest church steeple. But in 1543, they ran out of money and construction was halted. Only 300 years later was the church finally completed in its current form. Though completed is a foreign concept to Michael Hilbert, the master builder responsible for maintaining the Minster's structure. 24 workers are employed to check every single stone and to restore or replace them if necessary. It's exacting work for the 13 stonemasons, even if many details aren't visible from down below.
If you intend to restore a building like this, that's a national monument, you have to exhibit this attention to detail right down to the very last nook and cranny.
The Ulm Minster is a permanent construction site. Currently, the central part of the West Tower is being restored. We catch a lift 60 meters up. Here, every single stone is numbered. Michael Hilbert estimates that the wandering construction site returns to the same spot every 80 or 90 years.
It doesn't weigh on me that I'll never be done here and never leave a completed work behind. There's that famous saying, the journey is the reward, and that's the motto I live by.
Experiencing the Ulm Minster from a bird's eye perspective seems like an impossible feat. But the full body flight simulator Birdly and a VR headset can make it a reality. I take a virtual flight around Ulm during the 1890s. Free as a bird, I glide through the air and see the Minster up close. Really close, even.
Oh God! Oh. Oh, it was amazing, and I really felt like a bird when I was up there. It's like a total different world out there.
Back to reality. A big church needs a big organ, and the Minster's 8,900 pipes make a joyful noise. Friedemann Johannes Wieland is first organist and cantor here. He plays the king of instruments, as the organ is often called. German organ construction and organ music have even made UNESCO's list of intangible cultural heritage.
When we hold a church service, the music isn't just an extra. It's an important part of the service. It can serve to comment, create or highlight. And time and again, in life's extreme moments, when words fail us, music can speak and express emotions.
Sprechen kann, um ein Gefühl auszudrücken.
May I try?
That one, right? I'll add some of the pedal. Then I'll pull out all the stops. Ready, set, go.
Auf die Plätze, fertig, los.
Wow, it feels so powerful.
Es hat schon was Beeindruckendes.
There's something impressive about playing music at full volume. It's nice to play quietly, too.
Immer besonders schön, auch sehr leise zu spielen.
To be honest, many people only come to go up the steeple and enjoy the view, but some turn it into a sport.
At the annual Ulmminster Tower Run, athletes race up 560 steps to a height of 102 meters. I just have to give that a try. I can't match last year's winning time of 2 minutes and 36 seconds, but at least I finished.
I made it in 5 minutes.
The climb to the top is worth it, whatever your pace.
There are much higher viewpoints in the world, but to be on top of the Ulmminster with all the history around here is very special.
Even if it doesn't remain the world's tallest church forever, Ulmsminster will always be outstanding.